Okay, so for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at multiplying fractions. So when we've got a question when we need to multiply fractions, all we need to do is multiply the numerators together and then the denominators together. So for this first question, we've got to calculate and simplify 1 over 5 multiplied by 2 over 3. So because we've got to simplify it, we're going to see if we can cross cancel any of these numbers in this fraction. So all we do is go diagonally across the fractions from the numerator of 1 to the denominator of the other, and see if we've got a highest common factor which is greater than 1, which we can cancel these down by. So for 1 and 3, the highest common factor is 1, so we can't do anything there. Then looking across at the 5 and 2, the highest common factor there is also 1, so we can't cancel them down. So we're just going to multiply it through. So starting with the numerators, we've got 1 multiplied by 2, which gives us 2. And then we have 5 multiplied by 3, which gives us 15. So our answer to this first one, fully simplified, is 2 over 15. Okay, for this next question, we've got 1 over 8 multiplied by 2 over 5. So again, we've got to calculate and simplify, so I'm going to do the same as what I did before. We're going to see if we can cross-cancel any of these numbers. So first, looking at the 1 and 5, the highest common factor there is actually 1, so we can't cancel these down. However, looking the other way, we've now got 2 and 8. Well, the highest common factor of 2 and 8 is actually 2. So what we're going to do now is actually divide both of those numbers by 2. Well, if we do 2 divided by 2, that gives us 1. And if we do 8 divided by 2, that gives us 4. So now we've simplified, all we need to do is multiply across. So we've got 1 times 1, which is 1, 4 times 5, which is 20. So that one there would be 1 over 20. Okay, now we've got 1 over 6 multiplied by 5 over 7. So again, checking to see if we can cross cancel any of the numbers, we've got 1 and 7, highest common factor there is 1, so we can't do anything there. Then the other way, we've got 6 and 5, again, highest common factor is 1, so we can't cancel these down, so we're just going to multiply it through. So we've got 1 multiplied by 5, which is 5, we've then got 6 multiplied by 7, which is 42. So our answer to that one would be 5 over 42. We've then got 3 over 11 multiplied by 4 over 5. Again, seeing if we can cross cancel these, we've got 3 and 5. The highest common factor there is 1, so we can't cancel them down. The other way, we've got 11 and 4. Again, the highest common factor there is 1, so we can't cancel them. So we're just going to multiply it through. So we're going to do 3 times 4 first, which gives us 12. Then on the bottom, we're going to do 11 times 5, which gives us 55. So our answer to that one, simplified, would be 12 over 55. For our next question, we've got 2 over 3 multiplied by 1 over 2 multiplied by 4 over 5. So we're going to do like we did in the other questions. We're going to see if we can cross cancel any of these numbers, checking if any of the numbers on top have a highest common factor with any of the numbers on the bottom that is greater than 1. So just looking at the first two, I can see we've got this 3 and 1. Well, the highest common factor there is 1, so we can't cancel them down. However, we've now got 2 and 2. Well, the highest common factor of 2 and 2 is actually 2 itself. So we can divide both of those 2 by 2. And if we do 2 divided by 2, that would give us 1. So both of these would now be worth 1. Okay, looking across now, there's nothing else we can cancel on the top and on the bottom. So we're just going to multiply these through. So because we've got 3 fractions now, we're just going to multiply the 3 numerators together and the 3 denominators. So we've got 1 multiplied by 1, which is 1. Multiplied by 4 gives us 4. And then on the bottom, we've got 3 times 1, which is 3. Multiplied by 5 gives us 15. So our answer to that one would be 4 over 15. We can also have questions where we're multiplying a whole number by a fraction. But we can easily turn these back into questions like the ones we've just looked at by turning our whole number into a fraction. So we could turn 3 into a fraction by putting 3 as the numerator and then just putting it over 1. So we've now got 3 over 1 multiplied by 2 over 5. So now because we want to simplify as well, just like before, we see if we can cross cancel any of the numbers. Well, there's no higher common factor greater than 1 in 1 and 2, nor is there 1 in 3 and 5. So we can't cancel these down. So we're simply just going to multiply through. So multiplying the numerators together, we've got 3 times 2, which is 6. And then on the bottom, we'll have 1 multiplied by 5, which is 5. So our answer here would just simply be 6 over 5. We've got some more examples of these to have a go at now. If you want to try these first, feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these. And we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for this first question, we've got 4 multiplied by 2 over 13. So just like before, we're going to change our whole number into 4 over 1, which then we're multiplying by this 2 over 13. We can't cross-cancel any of our numbers here because we don't have a highest common factor that's greater than 1. So we're going to leave these as they are and just multiply them through. So we'd have 4 times 2, which gives us 8. Then we've got 1 times 3, which is just 13. So our answer to this one would be 8 over 13. We're going to do the same thing for this next question. We're going to have 3 as 3 over 1 multiplied by 7 over 20. So again, looking to see if we can cross cancel these numbers. We haven't got a highest common factor that's greater than 1, so we're going to leave them as they are. So then multiplying these fractions through, we have 3 multiplied by 7, which is 21. And then on the bottom, we'd have 1 times 20, which stays as 20. So our answer to this one would be 21 over 20. For our next question, we've got 5 times 7 over 10. So I'm going to write that 5 as 5 over 1, which then I'm multiplying by 7 over 10. So again, looking to see if we can cross-cancel any of these numbers. Well, the highest common factor of the 1 and 7 is 1, so we can't do anything there. But we can cancel down this 5 and 10. Our highest common factor of 5 and 10 is actually 5. So if I do 5 divided by 5, I get 1. And if I do 10 divided by 5, I get 2. So now multiplying these through, we're going to do 1 times 7, which is 7, and 1 times 2, which is 2. So this one, fully simplified, would just be 7 over 2. And for our last question, we've got 6 multiplied by 3 over 20. So again, I'm going to write that 6 as 6 over 1, which then I'm multiplying by 3 over 20. So again, looking to see if we can cross-cancel any of these numbers. We can't cancel down the 1 and 3, however, we can cancel down the 6 and 20. Because the highest common factor of 6 and 20 is 2, so I can divide both these numbers by 2. So if we do 6 divided by 2, that becomes 3. And if we do 20 divided by 2, that becomes 10. So now multiplying these numbers through, we've got 3 times 3, which is 9, and then 1 times 10, which is 10. So this one, fully simplified, would be 9 over 10. So well done if you followed along with those questions, and that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.